Very good afternoon to the students. Our next topic is the synchronous generator. As per the syllabus examination point of view also, the synchronous generator or AC generator or alternator. So in what way it is useful to our subject? So first, let us have a look at the dam. So dams are constructed. The main purpose, the primary purpose of construction of dam is to generate the electricity and then to store the water. So if you see any dam, the dam contains a large diameter pipe which is called the penstock. I'll show you here. Through that penstock, you can see these are the penstock pipes. Yes, this is the penstock. Through this penstock, the water with high pressure will be traveling through the penstock, and this water will hit the turbine, the rotating turbine. The turbine, which will act as the prime mover, will generate the mechanical energy. So generator converts mechanical energy to electrical energy. So how you generate mechanical energy? So first, water is stored at certain height, and that water is having potential energy. When it is passed through the penstock pipe, the potential energy is converted into kinetic energy with high velocity. And when the water with kinetic energy hits the turbine, when turbine rotates physically, mechanical energy is generated. This mechanical energy is given to the synchronous generator. Synchronous means same frequency or maximum speed. Now, this is the generator. So synchronous generator receives the mechanical energy from the turbine and starts to rotate. When it rotates, it generates electricity. You can see this is the animation of the dam, the idle power plant, we can see. Once again, the water is in the turbine rotates, and then that turbine is coupled to the generator. This is what happening in every dam, hydroelectric power, we say. So today's class, our topic is the synchronous generator, which is placed in all the power plants. We got Nagarjun Sagar Dam, Srisalam Dam. So if you get into that particular electrical part, you will see the presence of the synchronous generator. So synchronous generator is 100% question we can expect in the examination. The exact material also will be provided. Now, in basic manner, how to explain the synchronous generator? Synchronous generator generates electricity. It converts mechanical energy to electrical energy. Synchronous generator contains stator, rotor, and relative motion between stator and rotor. As I explained in yesterday's class, any machine if you want to develop, you must place the stator, rotor, and relative motion. Everybody know what is relative motion. So if one object is constant, another object is rotating, then only we can convert one form of energy to another form. Therefore, if you are developing any time machine also, or NASA spacecraft also, in that spacecraft, you are supposed to place a constant object, rotating object, and only one object has to be rotating throughout the time. So that is called the relative motion concept. So synchronous generator contains stator, rotor, relative motion between stator and rotor. You can ask one question, sir, three-phase induction motor also having same stator, rotor? Yes, any machine, these are the general terms used. So what is that stator now we are using? Stator of synchronous generator is armature conductors. Synchronous generator has the stator, but the stator contains armature conductors. Conductors, everybody know, the copper rods, copper wires, we can say. Armature means armature is the place where all conductors are placed. So if I'm having only one single copper wire or single conductor, I can generate very less amount of electric energy. But I want huge electricity should be generated. So I can place 300 conductors or 600 conductors. So all those conductors are placed in a... placed inside the armature. Armature is the place where all conductors are placed. Synchronous generator has the stator, rotor. Okay, stator, what is stator? We have written here. Rotor. So what is the rotor? Rotor are field magnets or electromagnets. So ordinary magnets, what you see, which will black in color and attracting small piece of iron, which are from the chemical to mechanical, their lifetime is very much less. So we go for electromagnets. So field excitation is the new word you will come into this explanation, which is nothing but the battery. Okay. So first we see what is field magnets. Then we put it in the explanation. Now, so just now I've shown you the dam where we place the synchronous generator. In our college also, we are having synchronous generator. You can find the huge synchronous generator is present in the college. Whenever the power supply is off, the generator we use to generate the power. Same process. Now, what is this electromagnet? I want to generate the magnetic energy. So first take simply in a simple terms, battery is connected to the copper wire. Copper wire is twisted in the form of circular shape. You can ask, sir, why we have to twist? If you are connecting copper wire directly, less amount of magnetic energy is created. In order to create maximum amount of magnetic energy, copper wire has to be twisted or rotated. But still, I want huge amount of magnetic field. So take one steel rod or iron rod or nail. You place that copper wire on that iron rod. Then what's going to happen? Iron and steel are good conductors of magnetic field. So with this circuit, you can generate maximum magnetic field. You can see here the strong magnetic field. So electromagnet means what? The device which generates magnetic energy. It is containing the battery, the iron rod, and copper wire. So wherever we use the electromagnet, you must understand it generates a magnetic field. Electromagnet or field magnet. So here, this is important. How to write in the examination? Synchronous generator generates electricity, converts mechanical to electrical. Synchronous generator generates dash current, AC current, alternating current. Okay, because we are not generating DC current with the help of synchronous generator. We cannot do. It is AC. How AC is generated also? Generated also, we'll see. Now, this is what we have done with the synchronous generator. Basic explanation. Now let us move and watch what exactly this synchronous generator is. The animation of the synchronous generator. This is a synchronous generator. What are the components? And synchronous generator also works on the principle of rotating magnetic field. You can see all of you. I can generate electricity by changing the coils. Okay, but we are not going for this method, which is a suitable one by using rotating magnetic field. That means synchronous generator works on the principle of rotating magnetic field. That magnetic field starts to rotate and conductor, you can see this one particular loop or one rectangle shaped conductor, copper wire, for a basic explanation we have taken. In synchronous generators, this point is very important. In synchronous generators, the stator is conductor. The stator is conductor, it is constant, and the rotor is magnetic field, always starts to rotate. How we rotate the magnetic field, we'll discuss here. So in synchronous generator, the third point you can write, in synchronous generator, as stator and rotor, stator is armature conductor, and rotor is electromagnet or rotating magnetic field. You can see here, magnetic field starts to rotate, the second one, and conductors are constant. Using this concept, we generate the electricity. It is the best one. So what is the structure of the synchronous generator? Synchronous generator contains stator and rotor. Let us have a look at this one now. Yes. Now, this is the stator here, this winding. Stator contains armature conductors, means number of copper wires are connected and placed, they are constant. Rotor is field magnets or electromagnet. Field magnets or electromagnets means what? It contains copper wire. You can see the copper wire. Copper wire placed on the iron material. And if DC current flows through it, if current flows here, the current flowing is not shown. If current flows through this rotor, magnetic field is created. But I want to generate rotating magnetic field. So what I am going to do? This is called the shaft here. This is the coupling device. So just now I have shown you one dam where water will hit the turbine. Yes or no? Water hits the turbine, turbine rotates. When turbine rotates, the shaft also rotates. And finally, the rotor of the synchronous generator starts to rotate. So first, before giving the explanation, I'm introducing each component. So the synchronous generator has got stator, rotor. Rotor contains the field magnets. When current flows through the field magnets, magnetic field is created. But magnetic field is what we do not require. We require rotating magnetic field. How to create rotating magnetic field? So when water from the penstock pipe hits the turbine starts to rotate, it generates mechanical energy. As shaft is connected to the turbine, shaft also starts to rotate. When shaft rotates, the rotor of the synchronous generator also starts to rotate. Now you can see the prime mover or turbine is rotating, rotor is rotating, and finally the rotating magnetic field is created. You can see here. Now this magnetic field, rotating magnetic field, is what we require. So this is the process in what way we generate. Rotating magnetic field is generated. Okay. What is the definition of rotating magnetic field? Rotating magnetic field is not constant. It rotates at synchronous speed. Synchronous speed is maximum speed, where NS is equal to 120 into F by P. Rotating magnetic field, which is developed across the rotor, it rotates through the air gap between stator and rotor and stator, and reaches the stator windings. According to Faraday's law, there is a relative motion between rotating magnetic field and stationary armature conductors. Now you can see this rotating magnetic field rotates and it cuts or links with the stationary windings, armature conductors or windings. As a result, current flows through the windings. Now let us see once again. Yes, this is the rotor, the field magnets I mentioned. Current is flowing through the winding. It generates the magnetic field. Yes, you can see here. So what is a rotor? Rotor contains the electromagnets. What is electromagnet? You pass the DC current to the copper wire, and copper wire, which is placed in the form of a circular shape or which is placed on the iron material, which is not shown here. When current flows through this particular copper wire, they generate the magnetic field. This is called the electromagnet. Okay, electromagnet is created, but I don't want only the magnetic field. I want rotating magnetic field. So what we do, we place this one on the iron or steel frame, and shaft is connected. Now with the help of prime mover, we rotate this turbine shaft, then rotating magnetic field is created. When the rotor rotates, rotating magnetic field is created. I want to generate huge magnetic field, so I increase the number of copper wires. Okay, so no need to show all these things, only for your understanding the rotating magnetic field is created. Now what is explanation? Rotating magnetic field is not constant. It rotates through the air gap between rotor and stator. And where the rotor is placed, let us go back to this explanation. You can see rotor is placed very close to the stator. So rotating magnetic field rotates at synchronous speed. You can see the formula also here in the animation. When it is rotating, what is the speed? Okay, we generate electricity. You can see, yes, this is what we require. N equal to 120 into F by P. So I do repeat here from the first time, very first basic. Synchronous generator contains stator, rotor. Stator is armature conductors. Number of conductors or copper wires are placed inside the stator. They are constant. Rotor is field magnets. When current flows through the field magnets, magnetic field is created, but we require rotating magnetic field. Therefore, the turbine, with the help of the water, starts to rotate. When turbine rotates, the shaft rotates, and finally the shaft, which is connected to the rotor, makes the rotor of synchronous generator to rotate in anti-clockwise direction generally. So when the rotor rotates, rotating magnetic field is created. This rotating magnetic field is not constant. Rotating magnetic field is not constant. It rotates at synchronous speed, NS equal to 120 into F by P. This rotating, according to Faraday's law, there is a relative motion between rotating magnetic field and stationary armature conductors. Therefore, this rotating magnetic field moves through the air gap between rotor and stator and cuts the stationary armature conductors. When the rotating magnetic field cuts the conductors, current flows through the conductors and hence electricity is generated. That current flows in one direction and then in opposite direction as we are having north and south pole. So that current will be AC current or bidirectional current. You can see here, rotating magnetic field rotates and thereafter it moves towards this particular stationary armature conductors and generates electricity. Here we are showing, yes, field magnets are this one. We generate electricity, rotating magnetic field. Yes, rotating magnetic field is generated. It rotates at synchronous speed. When it cuts the conductors which are placed in the stator or copper wires, then electricity is generated. Okay, this is for maximum electricity. No need to look into this one. Yes, this is what the stator, where all the stationary windings, copper wires are placed. Rotor is placed inside this one. Now you can see. So if you see, this is the stator. Where rotor is placed? Rotor is placed very close to the stator. Small air gap will be there. So what is this slip ring? This is important, all of you. So as a machine is, any object is rotating, and if you want to connect a wire to that particular object, we must use the slip rings. Slip rings are mechanical devices which are used to connect any element to the rotating element, which are used to connect any element or object to the rotating element. You can see the shaft is rotating. So I want to connect any external bulb. As we are saying, electricity is generated. So now with the help of slip rings, we connect. So slip rings are used to connect any element to the rotating element. Okay. So up to here, we close this one. I'll come back. Now this diagram you have to draw. So I'll show you the video also how to draw this diagram. Synchronous generator examination. This is the rotor. Synchronous generator contains the rotor. What is, where is the rotor? This is a rotor. The rotor is field magnets. Field magnets are, how many are there? North pole, south pole, north pole, south pole. So four magnets we have taken. And what is the name of this magnet? Salient pole, S-A-L-I-E-N-T. Salient pole means projected upwards. You can see this is nothing but the salient pole. That means it distributes the magnetic field everywhere. So magnetic field will be distributed everywhere. So only magnets, if I'm, these are iron material, north, south, all these are iron rods only. But I want to create magnetic field. So what I have to do, I have to place or wound the copper wire on this north and south poles. Okay, so we have placed the copper wire. How to place, I will show you the video also. You can practice the diagram. Synchronous generator diagram is important. I will show you how to draw the diagram also on net. So you can see it's the slip rings. So as the machine is rotating, I cannot connect DC supply battery to this one. So using slip rings, we connect DC supply to the rotor. So slip rings are used to connect DC supply to the rotor. That's enough. Okay. So now what is the explanation of synchronous generator, working principle of synchronous generator? So from first point we have tried. Synchronous generator contains stator and rotor. Stator is armature conductors and rotor is field magnets. So this is the diagram now. Okay. So directly if I explain the diagram, nobody can understand, but you see the working principle. When field windings, okay, when field windings of synchronous generator, these wires are nothing but windings, we say field, because they are creating the magnetic field. Right. When field windings of synchronous generator are excited with the help of field excitation. Another name for DC supply or battery is field excitation. When field windings of synchronous generator are excited with the help of field excitation, current flows through the field winding, which is called the field current. Current flows through the field winding, which is called the field current. Called field current. Due to the flow of field current, a magnetic field is created. Yes, current is flowing through the all the copper wires. Due to the flow of the field current, magnetic field is created. Now, with the help of prime mover or turbine if the rotor is rotated. Now, with the help of prime mover, if the rotor is rotated, rotating magnetic field is created. I hope this explanation is quite understandable. So now we see the diagram. First, let me share with the diagram how to draw the synchronous generator. So all students, I'm just sharing this one. Now you see. So on the paper, you practice all of you. First, I want to draw the four iron rods, that is four magnets I have to create. So you just draw neatly. You have seen the diagram. Okay, I can draw in this manner here. So four poles, iron material you can take and connect them like this. Just curvature, curve line you can get here. Okay. And this, it is called salient, means it, the top layer will be in this manner. Okay. So the magnet. So in order to distribute magnetic field everywhere, we use this type of connection. You can see the diagram. We are just drawing now online. So four magnetic poles we have taken. Let us connect. Now, only iron material if you are taking cannot generate electricity. You have to place the copper wire. Copper wire is wounded now. So copper wire is wounded, but I am taking the slip rings. Okay, this is the diagram for the slip rings here. So that small circle is nothing but the shaft. Two slip rings will take, yes. This is the slip ring one and lower one is slip ring two, and small circle is the shaft where we can connect the turbine. The slip rings positive and negative terminal are shown by this rectangular box. So one will be positive, another one will be negative. Okay. Now we must connect first the battery or field excitation. So here we show in our diagram by positive terminal. Positive terminal wire is taken, copper wire connected to the positive of the slip ring S1, and from the slip ring we place that copper wire onto the poles. Now you can see. Now this is the end point. Okay, anyway you can draw. You see that it is, yes, now it is connected from pole one to the another pole. So first one will be north, another one will be south. You can see that two number of turns here. Okay, so from here again it is carried to the another pole. Okay, from another pole to the last one. Yes, now it has come back to the slip ring S2, negative terminal, from the negative terminal to the supply field excitation. This is the rotor. Now rotor is placed inside the stator here. So current flows through the, yes, current direction. Without current direction, you will get zero marks. The current always flows from positive terminal. It flows through the pole 1, pole 2, pole 3 and pole 4. So this diagram neatly you draw. Okay, just I showed you in the diagram. So here, this is the field excitation. Okay, this is the synchronous generator diagram, the basic thing, that the field. So now I'll explain here. Now, what is the explanation? I can explain here what is the working principle. When the field windings, these are field windings here. When the field windings, let us go back to this one, the slide. And now you are in a position to give the explanation. So let us go back to this one. What is the explanation? What is the working principle of synchronous generator? When the field windings of synchronous generator are excited with the help of field excitation, the DC supply, current flows through the field windings. This current is called field current. Due to the flow of field current, a magnetic field is created across the windings. Now with the help of prime mover, if the rotor is rotated in anti-clockwise direction, then rotating magnetic field is created. Okay, rotating magnetic field is created. So again, for your understanding, we go back to this one. Okay, rotating magnetic field is created, as I mentioned, when the prime mover, when the rotor of synchronous generator is rotated with the help of prime mover, the turbine, the rotating magnetic field is created. This rotating magnetic field rotates at synchronous speed, ns equal to 120 into f by p. Rotating magnetic field moves through the air gap between rotor and stator and cuts the stationary armature conductors. According to Faraday's law, there is a relative motion between rotating magnetic field and stationary armature conductors, and hence the current flows through the armature conductors once in one direction and then in other direction. In this way, we generate the electricity using synchronous generator. Ultimately, mechanical energy is converted into electrical energy. Now let me share what we have done in the lab. In the lab also, we have done the experiment, synchronous generator. You see, this is the synchronous generator near the your workshop. You are having this lab. On that day, we have taken, this is the synchronous generator. Okay, I am not having prime mover turbine in the lab, so I connect one motor and rotate generator. When generator generates, you can see these three lights, that electricity is generated. Okay, you can see in the video. Yes, this is the shaft coupling device, so it rotates. You can see it starts to rotate now, supplies on. So this is the electricity we are generating, all the voltages regarding the synchronous generator. So to what extent it is understood, we'll see.